Hi guys, good afternoon to all my lovely and cherished viewers. Once again, my name is Mr. Adams and I am here to share with you a very, very interesting topic. Of late, a lot of things are happening. And if you look at the topics I've treated recently, I'm always been talking about relationships, because this is something that, whether we like it or not, people are into it. People are into relationships, and it is becoming something else. In the past, when you were in a relationship, you feel happy, you feel loved, you are happy because you love the person and the person also loves you back. But today, why is relationship becoming a taboo? It is like relationship is becoming a taboo because most of the things that we are hearing of late, killing, stabbing, and those things, recently, I think 2 days ago, I read somewhere where they said a 15-year-old has stabbed the boyfriend to death. A 15-year-old girl has stabbed the boyfriend to death. And before that, we all heard what happened at Damango, where the guy kill the girl friend, the police constable. We have to be very, very careful. Look, these things are happening quietly in our societies. And I don't know why, when we go to church, when we go to mosque, opinion leaders, elders, I don't know why they don't preach these things either in the church or in the mosque. Because whether you like it or not, we all know that 99.9% of Ghanaians either go to church or they are Muslims. The remaining percent is those who are into traditional religion. So what I'm saying is this. Parents should always sit down with their children and let them know that, look, when you are in a relationship is not all about, it's not always rosy. At times, you need to face certain challenges in a relationship. And you cannot handle your relationship if you are not patient. Look, I personally, I am a very quick-tempered person. I know about that. And anybody who comes close to me knows that that is how I am. I'm a very quick-tempered person. So what happened is that when I find out that this thing is going to provoke me, I quickly move away from it, because we do certain things out of the blue. We are not murderers. Those people who are committing murder here and there, killing their girlfriends or killing their spouse, they are not murderers. It is the situation, just a moment, and they act. They could not control their temper and they ruin their lives. So what I'm trying to say here is that people who are into relationship must make sure that you have to know your partner very well. You have to know your partner very well. Whether you are the man or the woman, you must know how your partner reacts to certain situations. I am talking about this issue because of the way things are happening. Just yesterday or 2 days ago, another police woman was found dead in the hotel. What was he doing in the hotel? And what happened that he have to die inside the hotel? You see, it is worrying. It is worrying. And if people like us who want to always talk about relationship, why relationships are becoming something else today, even when your daughter or your son is in love, then you are not comfortable. Because anything can happen. Anything can happen. And there are so many factors. I've been saying that the reason why in the past my father was not having problem with my mother, or our parents were not having problems with our mothers, is because that time the lifestyle was different from today. The lifestyle at that time was different today. People were disciplined. People respect each other. And for that matter, if I know that this person, this is the girlfriend, this person, this is the husband, or this is the boyfriend, I will not even try it because I know that the person is already in love. But today, it's not like that. Today, it is not like that. What people are doing today is that once they found a girl and they realize that they are better than the girl boyfriend, then they want to take advantage. They want to use their money and go and take the girlfriend from that person. And there are people who will not allow you to do that. There are people who will not allow you to do that because they believe that you cannot intimidate them because you have money or because you are better than that. Then, so you want to use your power, you want to use your money in order to take their girlfriends or their boyfriend. So what happened is this: it is leading to a lot of actions being taken by these people that at the end of the day, it is the one they love that suffers. The one they love that suffers. 2 weeks ago, a gym instructor was killed because he was what? It was believed that he was sleeping with a married woman. Even as of today, as I'm talking right now. After that, we've heard so many different stories. And if you, I did a program on this, I did a topic on this particular case. And I said that until the lady in question comes out to talk to the police or tell the police why the guy was killed, or what happened, because the lady was there the moment the bandits came to kill the guy. The lady was there. So the lady will be in a better position to tell the police what actually happened. Or if they are able to apprehend the culprit, they will be able to tell everybody the reason why the guy was killed. So we should not jump into conclusion and say that the guy was killed because he was sleeping with a married woman. Later on, we all realize what happened. Whether it is true or not, they interviewed the guy, and then the guy said, they interviewed the lady, and the lady said he was divorced 10 years ago. Whether it is true or not, I will not be able to be to confirm whether it is true or not. I went through the comments that people were making. People were saying that it is not true, she's lying, she wants to cover up, and all those things. Fine, that is their opinion. But I'm saying that it is becoming worrying. So if after that incident, someone was killed because it is believed he was sleeping with a married woman, some few days later, a police constable was killed by the boyfriend. Just 2 days ago, 15-year-old girl stabbed the boyfriend to death. And just as we are about to find out what actually happened, a policewoman was also found dead in a hotel. This should be a problem. This should be a wake-up call to people in power, people in positions, elders, church leaders, politicians, and parents, especially parents. Parents, when you see your son or daughter in a relationship, it is your duty to sit him or her down and let him understand that. Look for these signs and make sure that when you start seeing this kind of things happening in a relationship, be very, very careful, because people are losing their lives just for the mere sake of jealousy. And people are eager to take people's lives just like that without doing further investigation. We have all dated before. We've all dated before. And we've all passed through what is going on here. The reason why some of us did not kill, or other people did not kill their partners, is because they were able to control themselves. They were able to control themselves. Now, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something that happened, that I experienced it. I saw it with my naked eye. A man caught the wife in bed with another man. You know what he did? When he got home and knocked the door, he peeped through the window. He saw the man sleeping with the wife. He did not say anything. He had a spare key. He opened the door, came in, picked a beer from the fridge, cooled his temper, and waited for them to finish. They didn't know the man was in the husband was at home. The husband has arrived. Was sitting at the hall waiting for them. They were in the bedroom. When they came and they saw that the man was taken beer, so they were surprised the time how he came in and why he was taking cool drink at that time. The man did that because he didn't want to commit murder. So they were so surprised. When the man came out and saw the woman husband, he was so scared, thinking that something was going to happen. But the man didn't touch the man. He only asked the man to leave his house. After he left, that very day he did not talk to the wife. He waited because he wanted to know that what he was going to do was right. So he had to take time, think of it before he can confront the wife about the issue. So 2 days later he confronted the wife. Let the wife know that once it has gotten to a stage where he started sleeping with another man, it means that there's something wrong and the wife might not love him. I always have something. There's something that I always see that people have to take a clue of from it. It is very, very important. I always see that when a man cheats on his wife, he still loves the wife. A man can cheat with this. A man can love the wife so much that still cheat on the wife. But when a woman cheat with another man, it simply means that he doesn't love the man anymore. She doesn't love the man anymore. That is what I strongly believe. Because men can cheat with other women and still love their wife or their girlfriend so much, but they are doing it because cheating is in the blood of men. But when a woman begins to cheat, when a man provides everything for a woman and the woman still goes out there and cheats, then the man should be concerned. There should be a wake-up call that there is something that the man is not doing, or the woman has just decided, or the love he has for the man is depreciating, is decreasing, and the man has to be concerned. So this particular man's story that I just gave, you could see that by the time the man was about to confront the wife, he has relaxed. He didn't take action immediately. He made sure that he was in a good mood before he confronted the wife. And what happened? He told the wife that it simply means that you don't love me anymore. For that matter, pack your things and leave. Pack your things and leave. This is what the man did. This is what the man did. Now, the woman, after that, tried to beg, brought a lot of people to come and beg, church elders, whatever, did confess everything. But the man still insisted that he is filing for divorce. He did the right thing without necessarily getting himself into trouble. This is a very, very intelligent man. This is a wise man. If he had taken action immediately he saw the two of them, the man wouldn't be free today. Maybe he would have killed the guy or killed the man, a woman, and he would end up in prison. So I strongly believe that women or men should be able to be know how to control their temper. Like I said, I'm a very quick temper, but I have dated before. I have dated before. And I am one of the most jealous person alive. But I've never found myself in trouble, even when I was dating. Not that the woman I was dating, or not that before I became who I am today, I didn't have problem with girls who were cheating. No. Whether I knew about it or not, I always believe that you don't need to trust a woman. Let's pray that you don't see it. When you make your mind like that, you'll be able to live happily in the relationship can go far or the marriage can last. But if you made a habit that my wife is cheating or my girlfriend is cheating for that matter, I have to do everything humanly possible to find out. It will affect you in your job, it will affect you in every part of your life. And if you don't take time, your future becomes bleach. Your future becomes something else. So what I'm saying is that if you are not care in a relationship, if you don't take care in a relationship, most at times the end result is very, very bad. So why are they killing each other? Why are people in a relationship killing each other? Why? I strongly believe that it is jealousy. And you know, let me come in here. You know, relationship is not like marriage. When you are married, people know that this is your wife, so they will try to sit you down, counsel the two of you how to solve problems in your marriage, how to do it. Some people even go to marriage counselors for counseling, so that they will know that these things will happen and this is how we are going to behave when we find this kind of things. An old lady told me some time ago that when you are fighting with your wife and you are too angry, just get up, take your car, or if you don't have a car, just walk out, go somewhere, let her talk whatever you want to see, go out and come back later in the night when things calm down. That is a wise decision. It does not necessarily mean that you can't fight the woman. You can equally do, but let me tell you something. Because women are weak, they have sharp tongues, and women can say things to you if you don't take time. If you want to follow them, you will kill them. If you want to follow them, you commit suicide. So an old lady advised me some time ago that, young man, are you married? If you are married or you are in a relationship, anytime you have an argument with your wife or your girlfriend, please just leave the place and return later. You heard me? I said yes. And it has saved me a lot of times. I'm still free today because of the kind of person I am. Like I said already, I'm a quick-tempered person and I can easily lose my control. So what I'm doing is that I know this is my problem. So if you are a lady and you are somebody who is close to me, you must know this. And you should not try to test my weakness. Do not try to test my weakness, because if you test my weakness and I'm not able to withstand that test, anything can happen. So it is an advice. I always say that let's try our possible best to monitor the behavior of our words, whether especially when we expect them that they are dating. At times, whether they introduce the boy to the family or the girlfriend to the family, I don't know. But what I'm saying is that once you get to know that your daughter or your boy, your son is in love, is dating, you also have to sit him down and say certain things to him, educate him. Because some of these things that they are doing, it is just that they are innocent, they are ignorant. They are ignorant and they allow their hearts and their behavior to take control of everything, and it is landing a lot of them into trouble. Can you imagine, as a parent, you've paid so much school fees, you have invested so much in your son, he has completed university and he's about to get a job so that he can also take care of you, and because of a woman they are putting him life in prison. So all the investment that you have done, it has come to nothing because of one moment, because of one moment, one second of rage. All the money you spent on him is gone because of what he has done, because of a woman. So it is a concern. So when it happens, like, who are we to blame? Could your son have behaved differently, or could your daughter behave differently if he had an advice, for counseling from the parents? It is indeed sad Like I said, it is dangerous. The killings are happening. The killings are happening. They are dying. People in relationships are dying. And it is sad. It is sad. What is going on? What is going on? Recently, I read somewhere where a married, someone who has got just got married, married like the weekend, and then 2 days later, he was found dead in the river. Did he go there to die, or somebody killed him and sent him there? What is going on? Those who are dating are killing themselves. Those who are married are also having problems, are also getting killed. So we have to actually look into this, that relationships will always be there. Like once your daughter is 17, 18 years, they begin, the boys will start coming. The young men will start coming after them. And if you are not careful, that is what is going on. So when you give birth to a child, a girl, you have to know that you have a challenge. Especially if you have daughters. I always say that what I would do is that when my daughter grows up, or my daughters grow up, what I would do is that at the front of my gate, put, beware, I have a gun. Beware, I have a gun. That is what I'll piece in front of my door, my main gate. Beware, I have a gun. That's what I'll piece in front of my main gate. In order to let these jobless young guys who go around impregnating girls anyhow to come closer. Because once they know that this girl father has a gun and he's a very, very serious person, they will not try. Because it is so sad that you've taken all your life to take care of your daughter for just a jobless person, useless vagabond, killed her because of jealousy, because he was dating. I'm not surprised that when we watch movies or this thing, normally most of the parents, the wealthy parents, they don't want their daughter to marry vagabonds, useless, jobless people. They normally don't do it. We think it is in the movies. But in real life, you imagine that you have trained your daughter, spent, invested in your daughter, and at the end of the day, he goes and be following a jobless, useless, vagabond, weed-smoking person. That it doesn't make sense. No matter how you love the person, I will never accept it. I won't accept it. That is not love. That is not love. If you really want to love, this is not the kind of people that you have to love. Every parent wants his son-in-law to be somebody he can boldly show to people that this is my daughter's husband or this is my son-in-law. So if you go and you are following wisdom, because these are the people who end up killing them. These are the people who end up harming them. They don't benefit anything from the relationship. And yet at the end of the day, they can easily take your life. They can easily kill you. So relationships, we have to be very, very careful. Because these guys are very, very young. 15-year-old killing the, stabbing the boyfriend. They are young. And they might not even know the problems they are putting themselves in. They don't know. They don't know. So, we have to let them understand that when you do A, B, C, D, this is what will be, this is what will happen to you. You'll be arrested, you'll be jailed if possible, you'll be sentenced to life. And let me tell the young guys and the men out there, when you rape a woman or kill a woman, They normally choose a woman judge. They normally choose a woman judge. And women protect their fellow women. Women protect their fellow women. So if you find yourself killing your girlfriend or raping a woman and they arrest you and send you, and then you go to court and the judge is a woman, you are dead. You are dead. Because they will never favor you. They will give you a sentence that even your grandchildren will come and pay and continue paying it. Even if they abolish the death penalty, a lady judge, a woman who is a judge, sitting in a rape case or sitting in a murder case that a woman is involved, can easily sentence you 2,000 years. I know they can do that. So let's be careful. We are talking about sicknesses. When your daughter or son is in love, or when they are going out, you talk about they should protect themselves. They should protect themselves from sicknesses. They should carry condom. They should do this. They should do that. But we all forget to also talk about the way they handle the relationship. The way they handle the relationship. So, I strongly believe that we actually have to not only tell them that, be careful, not take your condom, protect yourself because of teenage pregnancy, all those things, but we have to also let them understand that it is high time they are able to solve problems amicably, no matter the condition. Because nowadays, you have your girlfriend, you laugh together, and somebody from somewhere, boom, come with some few dollars, some iPhone, some goodies, even pizza. People can easily take your girlfriend because of pizza. People can easily take your girlfriend because of KFC. People can easily take your girlfriend because of phone. That is the way it is. That is the way it is. Because the olden days, these kind of things were not happening because the temptation were not there. There were no temptation like this. You were not challenged. You were not challenged. When you are dating your girlfriend, you are free. You don't fear anything. Because even nobody will try to come and take your girlfriend from you. Nobody. Nobody, because they respect the value of relationship. So if I know Mr. A, this is Mr. A's girlfriend, no matter how beautiful it is, no matter how rich I am, I will not even try it because I know she's dating this person. But nowadays, it is not like that. Even people who are married, they still want to confiscate their wives from them because they might have money more than you. They might have some cash. They are better than you, so they want to use that one. And the women will easily accept it because of materialism. Only few women don't like materialism. And lots of women nowadays are addicted to materialism. And that is the reason why we have all this kind of confrontation. We have all this kind of problem happening. Because some people are not good losers. Some people are not good losers. They are bad losers. So we have to be very, very careful. You think that you have everything. You can bring your money and take somebody, girlfriend. But at the end of the day, the person takes revenge by eliminating you. So, let our youth of today understand that if you are in a relationship, anything can happen. You are not married. You are not married to the person yet. So, anything can happen along the way. And for that matter, you have to be ready to face these challenges. You have to accept that these challenges will come. There's no way you can be dating a good girl, a very beautiful girlfriend, and expect nobody to come and compete with you. People will come and compete with you. And like I said, nowadays, ladies, they love money. They love materialism. And for that matter, when somebody comes and starts dashing them these goodies, Not dashing them this materials that they need, they so desire, like the iPhones, the pizza, the KFCs, and money. They easily fall, they will even forget that they have a boyfriend. So, the young guys, they have to understand that. When you understand that, then you know where you are heading to before you go into a relationship. There's a program I watch on DSTV called Cheaters. I love watching that program. And when you watch the program, you will see how people betray each other. You see how people cheat on each other. It's a reality show. And you see how things are happening. So, as a young guy, I'm not talking about only the guys alone. I'm talking about both. As a young girl and a young guy, when you think you are mature enough to go into relationships, you have to prepare yourself, prepare your mind, prepare your heart, prepare your temper, prepare everything. And then make sure that you'll be able to face, because there will be challenges. You are going to have competitors. Either another girl is taking your great boyfriend, or another man is taking your girlfriend. So you have to prepare for this. Jealousy will come in. Competition will come in. People will not allow you just to enjoy with your girlfriend like that. No. People will tempt your girlfriend, especially when the lady is beautiful. Or when the girl is, like I said, when the girl is beautiful. Men will, different type of men will come. The girl can love you so much, but the temptations will be too much for her to handle. And for that matter, you the guy, you the man, you have to know how to face these challenges. You have to know how to fight back, to fight your girlfriend. You have to know how to solve this kind of problem. When you see that there's nothing you can do, just quietly opt out. Just quietly quit the relationship. To save your family from problems, to save yourself from going to prison, to save your soul. Because most of the times when they commit murder, at times they try to kill themselves. The only solution they want is that they want to kill themselves so that they will not face the law. They will not face the law. So they end up killing a girlfriend and then committing suicide. Look at all this. Look at all this. That is the more reason why I am saying that we as elders, I'm calling myself an elder because my daughter is growing up. She's growing up very soon. She also, and it is a headache to me. Really, it is a headache to me. Because once you have a girl who is growing up, you have to look at the location, the area. You have to be vigilant because the guys nowadays, they don't have mercy. There are some of them who doesn't have anything to it apart from chasing women. Some of them, that is their job. And like I said, I put there the African. So leave my daughter alone. African, leave my daughter alone. Because if you try, a vagabond, troublous, nobody wants a daughter to stay with them forever. No. Everybody would love to see their daughter get married. But not in this manner. Not in this kind of relationship. Not dating vagabonds, useless people without future, people without ambition, people without vision, and you find your daughter chasing after this. And at the end of the day, these are the people who normally murder them. These are the people who normally kill them. Run away. The person doesn't even have hope. He's hopeless in life. So he only put, he only makes you sad. He only commit murder. Let you suffer. You the parent to suffer, to grieve over your daughter. So as parents, let's be very, very careful, especially those who have daughters. I have daughters. And that is my headache. It is a headache to me. How I'm going to make sure that these people grow well, people attend school and become important people in society, will be able to withstand the test of these vagabonds on the roadside, these vagabonds in their schools, these vagabonds roaming anywhere. We have to be careful, because if you don't take these measures, as they are very young, let them know that dating will only mess their future. Dating will only mess their career. Dating will only mess their hope. Let them know this. Train the child from the beginning as they are growing up. When I'm home and I know that my daughter or my daughters are supposed to be home and they are not home, the others are very small. They are very, very young. They are very, very young. But my first daughter is the one I'm talking about. It is headache. How do I control this? Do I have to follow her around? Do I have to do too many times sent her? But I always sit her down and let her know that, look, if you allow any vagabond to put you in family way, you see this house, you will not enter. Because I will not go and commit murder and go to jail because of you. I won't do that. So when you go and mess yourself up, don't come to this house. You have to keep hammering on your daughter. You have to keep hammering on your son. Also, if it is a son, make sure that you let him know that. If you put a girl in a family way, or if you go and create a problem because of relationship, because of love, don't come to this house. Don't come to this house. Because I will disown you. I can invest in you, send you to school, educate you, do everything for you, and then because of love, because stupid thing that you don't even understand, then you go and create problem for me, go and create problem for your mother, making all our investment become waste. We will not understand this. So if parents are doing what I am saying, then we will not be having our daughters being murdered by vagabonds, hopeless people, useless people, and so on. We want our daughters to have a good relationship with responsible people, with responsible families. And people, there are some of them, when you see them, there's no hope. There's no future for them, because if you see someone who has a vision, who has ambition, you will know. You will know. Unless you pretend not to know, and you will know. Nowadays, I don't know what is going on. You give birth, and most of the children is girls. Girls. There are a lot of women more than men. You're in the house, you give birth. As a man, you give birth 5 children, 3 children, 4 children. And 4 of them are girls. At times, all of them are girls. And you have to find a way to educate these people properly. And once they grow up small, then the vagabonds will start. Their eyes can see beautiful things raw. When the ladies are raw, the young girls are raw, they are not growing up, their brain, they are not intelligent enough. That at the time, they confuse them with biscuits, with egg with pepper, and these are the things they buy for them, toffees and other things, and start sleeping with them. No matter how rich you are at home, your daughter will still go, and a vagabond will give her fried rice, will buy her fried rice and cook and other things, and easily get into her pants. So, we have to concentrate on our daughters. We have to concentrate on our daughters and let them understand what it is, how difficult it is if you allow a vagabond to impregnate you. Even anybody, concentrate in your education. If not, a 15-year-old starting a boyfriend 20 years, why should 15 years to be in school? And should not be in relationship. At times, some of these things are not controlled, because some of them, like I treated one of my topic about broken relationship, broken homes and other things. These are the causes. Because if you investigate this 15-year-old girl who stabbed the boyfriend to death, you will realize that maybe he's not living with the parents. The parents, everybody is gone. Either they are living separately, broken home, or he doesn't even know the parents. So it is better that we elders and family members and parents should be able to educate our daughters. I am saying all these things because, like I said, my topic is all about changing lives, protecting the girl child, protecting the vulnerable in society, because our young girls are in trouble. Even people who are old enough to be there, fathers, their grandfathers, are going to their schools and be picking them up and be going to sleep with them and be giving them these things. I know about it. I have done some investigation, and very soon, I think when it is time, I will try to bring it on air for everybody to see it. I've done some investigation, and if you see the kind of men that we respect who are sleeping with their young girls in, old enough to be their grandchildren, they pick these girls and go and sleep with them. How come that most of the hookers, they live at East Lagos? Because most of them are students. Most of them are students. And big people in society, they are taking advantage because they have the money to lure these young girls to, how will I put it, sleeping with them. And some of them give them some diseases, some of them impregnate them, some of them impregnate them and try to abort it, cause a lot of this. I will fight for the girl child. I will use my channel to fight for the girl child, because what is going on is very bad. And I blame parents, we parents, I blame elders, I blame anybody that has to do with who has a girl, who has a daughter. Let's be careful, let's be vigilant, let's train them, let's advise them. Let us know that relationship is nothing, it is not going to help them at the long run. They should rather concentrate in their schooling. They should concentrate in the class when they are in school to be able to write their exam and pass. Not allowing these vagabonds who stands by the factory, by the uncompleted buildings, and be smoking and be calling them, buying them fish, buying them biscuits, buying them, especially if your girl, your daughter is, you giving her biscuits and the mouth is sweet. This is these vagabonds, they are able to know what they want, and they take advantage. Though they are poor, they after pickpocketing some little money, they use it and call them buy biscuits. Sleeping with them. Some time ago, a rapist, he gave the girl only one CD. Young girl, they sent her and she was going to buy something and she knew her because of one CD. Because the young girl know that with the one CD, can buy biscuits, can buy palace biscuits. So, why are we allowing these things to happen as parents? As parents. So, this killing that is going on, I actually know the blame have to go to everybody. The blame have to go to everybody, especially parents, because that is where the whole thing normally starts. If you don't train your daughter properly, she can go out and take gifts from boys and men, politicians, because of materialism. That is your issue. Why is the relationship so bad nowadays? The killing is too much. And we will not sit down to pretend as if nothing is happening. It can happen to somebody's daughter. It can happen to your daughter tomorrow. Especially those in school. As I'm talking to you, if my daughter is going to SS, I'll be worried. Whether I should allow her to be in boarding school or day school, it is going to be another matter. Nothing can change. If it's coming from house, coming from school or going to school, these vagabonds, these boys, they can still leave here. If it's in school, these big men will still go there. Okay? So it's bad. So we, as content creators, like I said, you cannot be a content creator when the work you do, people does not benefit from what you say they are doing. When somebody watches my program, I know he's using data. I want at least at the end of the day, the person should get some information. The person should be informed. That is my ambition. That is my vision for this, my channel. So, almost all the time, I've been saying that, and I say something, that you cannot be a good journalist if the work you do does not impact society. You cannot be a good journalist, or you can't call yourself a good journalist if the work you do does not impact society. Minister Zoe said the name and Anas, they have decided that whatever that they are going to do, they are doing so that society will benefit from their works. If anything they will say, politicians, they can stop politicians from stealing our money and use that money to do better things for a community that we all will benefit. Is it not that? Is it not good? That is what we should be doing. So what I'm saying is that as a content creator, everybody has his own way of doing things. Everybody has his own niche. But as I'm sitting here, I've been seeing all along, there's no program that I do, and I will never mention that my program or my channel is about changing lives, about seeing things that will change lives. And I know with perseverance and hard work, people will understand. If you look at most of the most viewing content in YouTube are motivational speakers. They are motivational speakers. If you look at people, the millions of views, the millions of subscribers, most of them are motivational speakers because people want to be motivated. There are people who are hopeless. They are giving hope. They don't have anything in life. But with your words, with your advice, those people will find strength somewhere and chase their dreams and later on become important people. It's because the feedback doesn't get back to us. But I strongly believe we are changing lives. When I do a program and I watch my views and I see 50, 100, I know that out of the 100 people who watch this program, at least 3 people or 4 people, if they will understand or take my advice, I'll be very, very glad. Because changing one person's life is like you change an entire society. That is the message we want to put across as content creators. Depends on what you want to do. So, this is my particular topic. I am always, always insisting that parents should be blamed for all these things. Parents should be blamed for all these things. Because if we are able to train our girlchild and our sons very properly, they will be going and killing their girlfriends. Their girlfriend will not be killing them. They will not be doing that, because when you are well trained, you know what is wrong and you know what is right. And people who know what is wrong and what is right and are disciplined, they don't do these things, no matter the circumstances. Because if they want to commit a sin, they will think about the problem they are putting themselves in. So when you think about the problems you are putting yourself in, then you easily change your actions. You don't go ahead and do those bizarre things that you are doing to end up yourself. And like I always said, I don't wish even my enemy to be running away from the law. Because when you start running away from the law, one, that very day you start running from the law, you are not having freedom. You'll be hiding. And at the end of the day, you'll be arrested. And the day they arrest you, put to your plan, you will remain there until the bad judgment of you. And you continue from there. So why? And somebody will now be enjoying your girlfriend, even though because you are killing them. You do something bad. And then another one, recently a man killed the pregnant wife, because of jealousy, because he was suspecting the wife of having an affair. Or the wife was trying to divorce the wife wanted to divorce him. You see? And you are killing a person. What kind of society is this? Has society failed? And who are the society? It is the human beings that made up the society. So if society failed, it means that people in power, people that we call elders, parents, we fail. We have failed our incoming generation. We have failed to protect them. We have failed to protect them. That is the problem that I have. when I see this kind of things happening, I become sad. And I know that parents and opinion leaders, elders, we have failed the youth. Because what they are doing, some of them, if they were advised, if they were taught about the dangers of doing those things they are doing, they will never have even tried it. So let's be careful. Let's be very, very careful as parents. The killing is too much. The relationship issues are becoming too much. Man's killing the wife, wife killing the husband, girlfriend killing the boyfriend, boyfriend killing the boyfriend. It's not right. Something that is not right, let's all understand that. It is not right. These are young people who have a lot of potential that they can even use to help the country. But they have been committing some unnecessary things and been taken to jail for life. They rot there. Why? It's unfortunate. It is bad. It is sad. But like I said, let's all. I entreat people who watch my program to share my content. I'm a new YouTuber. I am not that long here. I am now trying to gather my audience. So it will be better if you share some of my content to your friends, your relatives, for them to also listen. Most of these things will not be happening if we are able to help each other by sharing information that we share on social media, we share on Facebook, we share on YouTube, we share on Instagram, Twitter, and all those platforms. It will help. It will help. What I'm saying here is common sense. Common sense. And once you have common sense, there are this kind of things you will not be doing them. You will not be doing this kind of thing that I'm talking about. Because common sense is far, far better than degrees without common sense. There are people who have degrees who have gone to the highest level, but they are doing some things that somebody with common sense will not do it. Somebody with common sense will not do it. So let's be careful. Let's be realistic and make sure that we protect our daughters. Protect them, the girl child. Let's protect them. Because women's minds are so small. And men are taking advantage. Vagabonds, hopeless people, hopeless guys, hopeless men. We smokers are taking advantage over them. Over our small girls coming back from school. They are luring them with biscuits, toffees, and Coke and Fanta. We'll be sleeping with them. And at the end of the day, they are the people who normally even end their lives. So let's be careful and watch the movement of our daughters because they are vulnerable. Let's be careful. That is all that I have for my audience today. I hope you enjoyed this program. If you watch it and you like it, please share it. Share it to your friends. Share it to your relatives. Share it until it goes viral. Because the message I am seeing here, or the message that I'm putting across, I strongly believe that it can change lives. That is the belief I always have. That is the zero. And that gives me strength when I know that what I'm doing changes lives. Thank you. And once again, my name is Mr. Adams. And may God bless you.